Welcome back to TenSlide Info. We all know that BrahMos Aerospace integrated the long-range supersonic cruise missile BrahMos on the Sukhoi Su-30MK fighters of Indian Air Force by modifying the avionics and also the aircraft structure. These Sukhoi Su-30MK fighters' airframes were strengthened in order to equip them with BrahMos A variant of cruise missile. This was a news which was celebrated a lot among the defense lovers and Indian Air Force, since equipping the Sukhoi fighters, which are said to be the backbone of Indian Air Force, would improve the combat power of these fighters to more extent. And this would obviously help them in keeping an eye in the Indian Ocean region of South India. On January 20, 2020, South India's first squadron of multi-role Sukhoi Su-30MK fighter jets, modified to carry the BrahMos supersonic cruise missile, was inducted at the Air Force base in Tamil Nadu's Thanjavur. This 222 Tiger Sharks fighter squadron at Thanjavur Air Base will provide the country with a new lethal weapons platform that will fulfill both aerial and maritime roles and guard the Indian Ocean region. India is very eager to export the BrahMos cruise missile to friendly countries, but in order to do so, they need to come up with something different than the BrahMos A variant. The reason why I'm specifying a new variant and not the BrahMos A is because not every country can perform such a structural changes to aircraft to equip their fighters with this variant of BrahMos missile. So what is the answer or solution for this? It's BrahMos NG variant, which is lighter and compact in comparison with the BrahMos A variant, which is going to be the solution for making sure BrahMos cruise missile gets exported. The new variant of the missile, which is BrahMos NG or BrahMos Next Generation, is an interesting weapon, and the feasibility studies and the engineering analysis shows that this missile can be easily fitted with any type of fighters without much or no modifications. To be more precise, the BrahMos NG is a mini version of existing BrahMos, which will have the same range and Mach 3.5 speed, but it will weigh around 1.5 tons, making it 50% lighter and 3 meters shorter than its older variants. Indian Air Force is also very eager to integrate these missiles once they are ready for induction to Sukhoi Su-30MK fighters, the Mikoyan MiG-29K, HAL Tejas, the medium weight fighter, AMCA. Not only that, BrahMos NG will also be integrated with the recently inducted Dassault Rafale fighters. The BrahMos Aerospace is planning to manufacture the BrahMos NG in Uttar Pradesh, and it should be ready for trial and the first flight by 2023 or 2024 tentatively. This program is mainly backed and supported by the Indian Air Force, and now seeing the features and the power of BrahMos NG, India can expect orders in the export market as well. Another point which attracts other countries is that the BrahMos NG will have lesser RCS, which is radar cross-section, compared to its other variants. And due to this, it makes it harder for the air defense system to detect these BrahMos NG missile. Not only that, BrahMos NG will have a land, air, shipborne and a submarine tube launched variants as well. So that was all about the vital information and the latest happening with the BrahMos NG cruise missile and how it would be able to attract the export market. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned to TenSlide Info for more defense and aviation related updates. Thank you.